Thank you for coming.
Excitement for science.
This is your 15th time on the show. Did you know that?
Wow.
We still have all of our fingers
so
and everything.
Far,
it's
yeah.
really wonderful.
Wow.
What are we going to do here tonight?
All right.
Science Bob.
So you you know, I love my favorite liquid, liquid nitrogen.
You do love liquid
I
nitrogen.
I do like liquid
yeah.
nitrogen.
You are the number one consumer of liquid nitrogen.
Probably in the
I
county.
I know, yes.
Hey, grab me those gloves, would you? Go ahead,
okay.
Let's put some gloves on.
All right.
And so this is a container of liquid nitrogen. So nitrogen is about 80% of what we breathe.
Okay.
And so if we, if they compress that, it gets very, very cold, and it's 321 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. It's very, very, very
it's cold.
Cold. Yes.
Yeah. Like if that was a pool, you'd never get in there.
You'd never know. It'd be the last thing you did.
Okay.
If you pour this on the ground or if you pour this on a flat surface, and you go ahead and give it a little try.
Do.
And you'll see how it dances across.
Yeah.
And yeah. almost like anti-gravity, right?
Yeah, it's great.
So that week, there's a name for that. It's
what?
Called the Leidenfrost effect.
Oh.
Leidenfrost effect.
Oh. Is that any relation to August cunts?
No. No. I don't know if they ever got along or not. So I thought I would give you a little try-at-home experiment.
Okay.
A little try-at-home experiment.
Mm-hmm.
These are little polymer orbs. So they start off as little BBs. You put them in water overnight, and they get these little squishy polymer orbs.
Where do you get these?
You know, florists use them. You can get them at toy stores because they're sort of a toy item.
Okay.
So you can get them. And if you take that and put it, we have a very hot pan.
Put it
this
in there?
This is like liquid nitrogen going on a surface because the floor to liquid nitrogen is super, super hot. So if you put that in there, what ends up happening... you can try another.
Be more gentle?
You take your gloves off.
I got the gloves. Oh,
yeah.
Why did you tell me to put the gloves on?
Well, for the frost.
Oh, all right. Okay. All right. Well, they're so free, huh?
Yeah, so that goes in there.
Okay.
And what happens, see how it dances around?
Yes.
So when it touches the pan, it emits a little burst of steam.
Okay.
And that actually gets it dancing around. You can put some more in it.
All right. Oh, look at that. Isn't that wonderful? Wow. And how long will they go on like that?
As long as there's heat there until they all dry up. So, you know, you could, you know, try it home. You need a very hot pan.
Uh-huh, yeah, sure.
Be careful.
Boy, the kids would love that, huh?
Yeah. I like the sound.
Yeah, I could watch this for like an hour. You know, they have channels with weird stuff like this, and you could, okay, all right, good, all right.
Let it cool off.
All right. Wow, it's like haunted jelly beans. All right.
So, I don't know how long it takes to stop.
All right, well, we'll find out, I guess.
All right, so now we're going to take that idea.
Yeah.
And we're going to show another cool feature about liquid nitrogen, which is that it expands a lot when it goes from liquid to gas.
Okay.
And we're going to kind of take advantage of that.
Should I put my gloves back on?
Yeah, we got new gloves if you want.
Oh, great. Wow, different gloves for everything, huh? How about that?
So what you're going to do is I've got a little container of liquid nitrogen here.
Okay.
And then I've got a ping pong ball.
Why do they look like that?
Well, you'll see why, because I've poked a tiny little hole inside of one side, the yellow side, and another one inside the black one.
Okay.
And what we want to do is fill it up with liquid nitrogen as much as we can, and then when it expands, the jets of gas, like nitrogen gas, will come out of here, and that should cause it to spin around.
Awesome.
All right, so grab a little clamp here.
Okay.
And we're going to, you can pick up one of those.
All
so
right.
So the yellow and black kind of helps us know whether or not it's spinning.
I see. Okay.
All right. So
very good.
Go ahead and dip that underneath so it's
hold
fully
it down.
Submerged. Yep.
Okay.
Submerge that in. Here, I'll get one too. So we got another one. So now, because the air in there is compressing, it's drawing in the liquid nitrogen.
Yeah, I know.
And so we get a little bit in there. All right. And that should be good enough. Go ahead and pop that into that tray there.
Okay. What if we put one in the frying pan? Would anything crazy happen? Oh, look at that.
Yeah, isn't that great?
That is good.
All right, let's see.
Another one?
Yeah, sure. We can see that spinning effect.
Yeah. All right.
There we go.
And now...
So...
We have...
I'll show you a different version of it.
Okay, good. All right.
So this is a larger version of a hero's engine.
Okay.
And so normally, again, they'd put a little water in here, they'd put some steam, and then we have opposing jets here that would then spin it around. But we don't really have time for the whole heat thing.
Okay.
So we are going to use our liquid nitrogen.
Thank you.
All right.
You know it gets serious when the masks come out.
Oh, yeah. Now, here's the thing. You enjoy chocolate milk?
What?
Chocolate milk?
Can't hear you.
So let's say you go to make a little bit of chocolate milk, right?
This is not how I do it.
This is not?
No, we use a spoon.
Oh, well, see, that's the thing. What if you don't have a spoon?
Okay.
So here, take that.
All right.
So pour in chocolate milk. I don't know how much chocolate you like in there.
A lot is the answer. All right.
That's good.
Okay.
All right. So what if you want chocolate milk and you don't have a spoon?
Hmm?
You don't have a spoon, but yeah. You do have a 12-inch stainless steel sphere and some liquid nitrogen. This is the way to go.
Okay.
All right. So, I'll tell you what, would you measure out, fill that cup up with some liquid nitrogen?
All right. Well, where will we get liquid nitrogen? Oh, right here. All right.
Go to your pantry. There you go.
Okay.
All right. And now we're going to pour that into our hero's engine.
Okay.
There we go. Oh, yeah, it's going in.
Is that enough?
Yeah.
Let's do all of it.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Let's really blow the lid off this thing.
Okay.
All right.
Which we actually might do.
Okay.
All right, there we go.
And again, we're making chocolate milk.
That's true.
At the end of this demonstration, there will be a glass of chocolate milk.
All right, let's see if we have any better luck here.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna really get that. We're gonna give a little head start.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I think it's, oh, I can feel it now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we're going, Jimmy.
It's going.
Look at it.
Here we go. Wow.
Wow!
Oh my God, it's gonna blow!
I think it's working! Oh my goodness! Alright! I think it's working! Wait! I think we put too much in! Alright!
Hold on, I'll get the tongs!
I'm going in! Hold on! Alright! Oh!
Wow! It's incredible!
Yes!
Science bottles. When we come back,
yeah.
What are we gonna? We're gonna have fire when we come
there
back,
will
right?
Be fire.
We're gonna have fire when we come back. We're back with Science Bomb, Pflugfelder. We're dressed like baked potatoes. Why aren't we dressed like this? What are these?
These are fire suits, and they're not just for show. We actually will need these.
And why isn't anyone else in a fire suit?
No, we're just putting ourselves.
We're going to be releasing toxic gas into the studio. Just try to hold your breath for about 5 minutes or so. Everybody will be fine.
Everyone will be great.
What are we going to do here? What's the
all
plan?
All right, so a long time ago, this is one of these wonderful scientific accidents.
Okay.
And this is just regular cotton, just like any cotton like you'd find. But there was a little accident, and it got mixed, this is back in like the 1800s, got mixed with some sulfuric acid and nitric acid.
That happens to me sometimes, yeah.
And it creates, of course, nitrocellulose.
Of course.
Nitrocellulose changes the molecular bonds of this, and instead of becoming cotton, it becomes gun cotton.
Okay, goo, gun
yeah,
cotton, I like
gun
that.
Gun cotton.
Okay.
And it burns much, much different. So if you were to burn this with just regular, you know, just light regular cotton, probably take a minute or two to burn. But you gotta, if you can get one of those little lighters there, and I'll hold this out, and we'll see how gun cotton burns.
All right. This is now burning gun cotton. Sheesh!
What the hell?
I know. Isn't that
it
great?
It didn't burn, it disappeared.
I know, and no smoke, no ashes. So
it's the perfect crime.
They actually ended up using this in World War II. They would use this in battleships, and so it's pretty cool.
Okay.
So if you take that and you compress it, then you get more of something like a weapon.
Oh, great.
All right? Mm-hmm. So we've got a little gun cotton at the bottom of this, and we thought, all right, we could just shoot it off, and magicians sometimes use this stuff.
Okay.
But let's have a little fun with it. So behind us is a series of 32 balloons.
Right.
However, unlike being filled with air or helium, these are filled with hydrogen gas, which is kind of flammable.
Okay, great.
So you're gonna
this could have killed that clown in the movie It.
I know. So we're gonna have you fire some gun cotton at that first balloon.
Great.
That's gonna explode, and we're gonna see if we can create a chain reaction that will blow all these balloons.
I would love to.
If it works, it'll go in like a second.
Okay.
But we've never actually tried it at this scale.
Oh, okay, great.
Yeah.
So I need to put this on?
Yeah, so let's get this on.
Okay.
And these hydrogen burns at about 1,000 degrees.
Everybody knows, Bob.
And then turn and face that balloon, and then come down on your knee, sniper style.
Now, are you putting that thing up my butt?
Here, right. Come on down.
Okay.
Bend down here.
All right.
Here we go. That's great.
All right.
All right, here's your Harry Potter wand.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to light the end of it.
All right.
And you're just going to point it at that balloon. Are you
okay.
ready?
I'm ready, yeah.
Here we go. In 3, 2, 1.
Instant replay.
Look at that.
Wow, this is how we're going to defeat North Korea, everybody. Science Bob. Thank you, Science Bob. Much appreciated.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Kimmel. If you enjoyed the video, hit subscribe. And if you don't click subscribe, this invisible hamster will die.